The Taliban launched an attack on Afghan security forces in Ghazni province of the war-torn nation. The attack comes just days after the US NATO forces extended an olive branch for peace talks. We have a report.
The Ghazni province in Afghanistan continues to be a target of the Taliban. Recently, as many as 14 Afghan soldiers were killed in Takhar area of the province. As per reports, 6 soldiers are missing and 16 were wounded in the attack on the military base in Khwajaghar. In the neighboring Kunduz province, at least 7 army soldiers were killed and several others were wounded. Taliban fighters have ramped up attacks on Afghan security forces and government facilities in recent months, leaving troops thinly stretched throughout the country. On the other hand, NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg urged the Taliban to stop killing fellow Afghans and join peace talks.
I call on the Taliban and other insurgent groups to stop killing their fellow Afghans. The use of suicide bombers in urban areas and the indiscriminate use of roadside bombs demonstrates a careless disregard for civilian lives. The Taliban must understand that continuing the fight is pointless and counterproductive. To be part of Afghanistan's future, they must sit down at the negotiating table.
NATO ended its main combat operation in Afghanistan in 2014 and since then has provided training and assistance to Afghan security forces. A total of 39 countries contributed around 16,000 troops to the NATO-led Resolute Support Training and Advisory Mission. Speaking at the news conference, along with Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Stoltenberg said, NATO remained committed to the mission, which it saw a guarantee of security of member states as well as the Afghan people.
Together we train, advise and assist the Afghan forces as they work to make this country safer and more secure, and prevent it from ever again becoming a safe haven for international terrorism.
The Taliban have ramped up attacks in strategic provinces in their battle to expel foreign forces, topple the Western-backed government and restore their version of hardline Islamic law.
NATO stands with Afghanistan because stability in this country is important for your security, but also for our security. We stand together in the fight against international terrorism.
Pakistan, on the other hand, has continued its efforts to derail peace talk efforts. The assassination of Maulana Sami-ul Haq, who the ISI believes would have got the Afghan Taliban on the negotiation table, has further complicated the issues and has also exposed Pakistan. The terror outfits, which have been causing mayhem in Afghanistan, have a strong connection with neighboring Pakistan. Pakistan has been accused by Afghan authorities for being the state which provides resources, training and weapons to carry out attacks to destabilize Afghanistan.